I'm Debra Baldwin. I'm at the Propagation Greenhouse of Succulent Gardens Nursery in Castroville, California, near Santa Cruz. And with me is the general manager of the nursery, Aaron Ryan. This man is such a pro at propagation. What a treat to have him show some of our, or some of his, really unusual and clever, but maybe not all that uncommon, techniques for creating new plants. Aaron?
Yeah, I think the most dramatic thing I've seen you do was taking that drill and coring a cactus.
Sure, yeah. So sometimes when you have a cactus that's stubbornly does not want to offset, this is a Helianthioceras tershekii. It's a very slow growing cactus, and it takes about 5 to 7 years before it can even produce seed. So before that happens, your only option to getting the offsets is to core drill it. So what you want to do is you want to destroy the apical center where all the new growth of the plant comes from. So all of the newest growth is going to be pushed right through here at the very tip of the cactus. It's easy to tell on a cacti because it's just right in the center where all these ribs meet at the very top of the plant.
Got it.
With other plants like echeverias, agaves, it's a little less defined, but it's usually at the very tip growth point where the newest leaves are forming.
So tip growth.
So what you want to do is by destroying the apical center, what you're doing is you're forcing the plant to put its energy elsewhere. So what it'll do is start pushing energy into creating new pups on the side. With the cactus, these are the areolas here, and that's where the new pups will be formed.
Okay, looks like you've got an aloe hitchhiking there.
Yeah, we have a little, I think that's a little aloe syncytana seedling. That
okay, those are not the new growth.
That's, right, that's exactly. Yeah, this is not to be confused with the cacti.
But the new growth will be like little buttons at first, and then they'll expand and they'll be clones.
And once they get to about a silver dollar sized plant, that's when you can start extracting those pups.
Okay, so
So you want to make sure you have a bit that's big enough to drill through. If it's too small, it's not going to be able to kill that, and so that apical center growth. So what I use is a 5/8 size drill bit here. It's a wood boring
bit. It's a wood boring drill bit, 5/8.
And I'm just going to place it right over on the top. And just go right down. And you want to drill down until you feel a little resistance on the base of the plant. You don't want to destroy the root system, so by drilling down to nearly the base, that's good enough. Then you want to recede the drill backwards.
Okay, so you feel that little bit of resistance because you're starting to reach where maybe the roots are formed at the
bottom. Right, exactly.
And you don't want to destroy or hurt that.
Right.
Can you err on the side of caution and maybe not drill as far down?
Yes, you do want to make sure that you drill far enough that you kill that central growth. Because if you don't, it can actually still form tissue from the base and you're not going to get your desired result from that. So you want to go down to, you can sort of see on the base of this cacti, this sort of callousy growth on the bottom.
Okay.
And that's the woody growth. So when you drill in, you feel when you hit that because there's quite a lot of resistance.
Got it.
And that's exactly when you want to hit that.
Okay. Well, I want you to send me a photo of that after it produces all of that new growth.
Yeah, we'll have to get a before and after. I have about 3 core now, so
okay.
Yeah, we'll send that up.